I'm going to ask you very politely, calmly, and nicely to get out of bed!
At the moment, I'm just popping out when I can to get a few hours in when I can. Basically, as you probably know, we're moving house and businesses, and it's a lot of hard work because like an hour plus between houses and stuff like that. And we're decorating the house at the other end, and yeah, just day and night moving, working. I'm absolutely knackered, but I'm squeezing in a few trips and I'll be going live as well, like I normally do. We'll see how we get on. By the way, my name is Carl. This is Waterside Fishing Adventures, and hopefully I'll see you on the bank at some point. So I'm off over to Bungie today. I'm going to have a little look along the Ditchingham stretch. Yes. Going to be around 7:30 by the time we get there. It's 6:30 now, and hopefully I'll be able to find a few chub I found a few weeks ago, drop some baits on their heads, and yeah, boy, not really sure, we'll have to see. Obviously that's quite dull. It's going to be an evening session. We've got what, it's dark about 9:30 now, and so we've only got a few hours. Get in what we can and we'll catch as many fish as possible. You know, so we can get a good sized chub or a food chub, some roach, dace, that sort of stuff. But we can only catch what we get a bite off, so we'll have a good go and let's see how we get on. back end of the road, and there's a little lake and a caravan site down there. Fancy getting a float out or something like that and have a little go. It's not very big, but this is right for a day out. Oh, I feel like I've been stuck on this mini for about an hour now. Got people up front taking their bike test, the looks of it. Take a little wander and see what I can find. I'll take it with me. Not sure what we're going to be able to see. Little cows in the field. This is a lovely pool to fish. There's fish coming up down the bottom there. Going to go in there today, I don't know yet, we might do. Down the other side here, which is not very fishable, but there's a little stream that runs through normally. Yep, they're there. Some huge chub just sitting down there. We'll just be able to see the back end of them there. So I'm going to get my stuff on, I'm going to see if we can get a bite. See you in a minute. Okay, so let's see what we can do. Just turn the bread on. Got a nice big hook on. boot straight off. But... I can see tons of little ones, but big ones too. Interested whatsoever, but we've only been here 5 minutes, so see what we can do. too good. Get huge bunch of small ones.
Yeah, but if you have the
medium,
give me a shot.
Mm-hmm.
See
you
out
of
weather.
Oh,
yeah.
Go, mate. Well, it's a real shame, but all the big ones are spooked, so there's not much I can do. Right, so what I'm going to do now is bait up under that tree there. Keep the bread under there. See if we can get anything down there. What you just got there? In about 2 minutes.
You didn't, you know?
Yeah, send us one of that. Nice ones up the bridge up at the top there, aren't they?
Done.
Big ones up the bridge
yeah.
Up there. Yeah, I've seen some quite nice chub up to sort of 5-6 pounds. But...
I've had them up to 5.
Yeah? Yeah, I've had a 5 down in the river there. I think there is a few good ones in the water. Mm. Let's try somewhere different here.
So a couple of barbies on there,
please. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. That'd be good.
I've seen Barbie's bear down at the old thing.
Oh, yeah, we're going to be in the end. You never know, you've got to try and then it's going to come out, don't
you? You could big chub land under there. That's quite deep there, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's shallow outside.
You look just off the beach, just down that side there, they are sitting there.
Yeah.
So as soon as you go there, they'll just be gone.
Yeah.
When you cast under that tree, there must be a back eddy, and you end up under these lilies.
Mm.
It won't go that way, I can miss it, so you put a bomb on them. So if you're like that, you just see them, you're not about to land with them. Just go on.
I looked the day before and they're all sort of swimming around. You can see them with Polaroids, and when I got here you couldn't see nothing.
Oh, what?
And I just came here and thought, oh, they're trotting back in down there. And they kept looking, and just where that fucking little ripple is there,
right.
You could just see them.
Yeah, I'll
see. They were just all laying on that ripple.
Oh, right.
Up there. So I just sort of creeped up there and fucking just floating bread down to them.
That is where I normally fish with them.
Yeah. Cut down they were all lying early morning just in that ripple. I had two ate pretty quick, and then as soon as I had them ate, they all moved in. That's they all drawed in here.
Yeah.
But they're just lying there, I suppose. It's... But I had a couple of nice ones down the mill.
Good size ones. Yeah.
My fish round. I just go to the mill. My fish right a little bit further around the corner where you can stand on the road and just flick in that wide bit.
Yeah.
And we went there, me and my mate went the day before the season and took some bread down there, and it was coming up the left hand side. Yeah. I mean, most of them, you know, 5-6 pounders.
Nice.
Nothing more. And you think, Jesus Christ.
That's what you want.
Again, see a couple of barbel in that bit as well.
Couple of carp.
See some carp moving about in the whirlpool.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah. I used to fish the whirlpool years ago. My dad used to work out some slaughterhouse, and the bloke he used to work with used to do gardening for right. The people who lived there. And when they used to go on holiday, he used to tell us. So we used to go and sit in their garden. I came past through here earlier, and there was a boy here with three rods.
Oh, right.
Looked like he was ledgering, but...
I normally just come
when I feel when the sun's really up, just flick a bit of bread in, or worms and that, free line it, and just drop it in, and you normally, if they're there, if you can see them moving a bait, as soon as you flick the bait in, then, you know, when the sun's out, you normally nail couple pretty quick, and then you sort of spook them a bit, and then it sort of take a while for them to come back.
But again, yeah. That next little bridge down, there's always a load there.
Yeah.
But they're only up to sort of pound mark, aren't they?
Yeah.
They've had some quite nice roach over here as well.
Yeah. They've got a bunch of nice perch as well.
Yeah.
I normally just creep up to that them logs.
Yeah, I look for
second something. Logs and then just flick them up right. You can see the old towels in there.
Yeah, it could be good.
Yeah, definitely on that.
You go for one down. Just took this guy now. So I've decided to move down the bridge a bit. Now I've got a load of cows around me. Coming to see what I'm doing, obviously. Right, so we're going to try this bit here. Right. I'm going to try over the back there now, along there. Well, I can see all nice chub on the sandbar down there. Decent sized ones, you know, 3, 4, 5 pounders. But these cows won't leave me alone. I tried to sit over there on my normal spot where the trees have been cut down, and these just come right up to me, sniffing the hell out of me. So, won't leave me bait and, you know, bread and stuff alone, so can't be dealing with that. So we're gonna have to move again. Oh, wow, not going to plan tonight. found a load of chub in two swims. One lot spooked off, and the other lot, well, the cows were just all sitting around me. Can't do nothing about that. They're just literally all over me, sniffing me, pushing me in from my back. So I'm gonna have to try another little swim, I know, and hope there's no cows there. So we'll whip down to that and see what's there. Oh, that's handy, so there's no cows in that field. But it's also not a lot of water, so let's have a look. Not one of my spots. If you know the channel, you know the spot. Are there any fish there? Yep, I can see some fish. Food chub down there. There's quite a few chub down there, actually. And then you've got the deeper part. There may be some bigger ones in there as well. So let's see if we can get a couple. Some food down there. Food down there around the pound mark. So that'd be nice. Bigger would obviously be better. So let's have a little go. Finally settled down and got a spot. I can actually fish. Yeah, let's hopefully we can catch a few bits and pieces. Ooh. I can see a few fish down there, so we've got a lot. Definitely fish moving in there. See if we can catch. A little waggler float on. Little crystal waggler float on. Surfers in there, that's right, isn't it? We've got some maggots up there. There's fish down there.
on the spot with a move. Push it on. Didn't take too long then. Nice little chubblet. That didn't take too long. There's our prize. First fish of the night. We've only had two casts, so not bad, is it? Alright, let's get it back in. I know where a few fish are now. I'm going to do so much talking, I'm going to try and show the fish being played in and stuff like that. Let's see what we can do.
On the bottom, or that's not very deep, that's deeper out there. Good with three red maggots. normally you get a bite here really quickly. Find the fish. Push it on. Another little chublet. Right, so you can see, got a little waggler, 1.5 BB float. Weight either side of the float, one to sink the line down slightly, and then we've got 3 white maggots on this time. Let's see what we can get. Been hard work tonight to try and get a swim because of the cows, but I think we found one. We had a couple of fish so far. Quite a few joggers and stuff going past, people walking dogs. And I think, as you can probably see, cows have seen me again, so they're all coming up to the fence. Strange, like the white maggots are not getting as many bites as the red. I know for a fact if I put a bit of bread on, all the small stuff will attack it. Struggling to get a bite on the white maggot.
Very strange. How can they take the red, not white? Oh, here we go. Oh. Just got to be in the right spot, haven't you? If you can see the float on the screen. Switch back to red maggots then. Should we put bread on? We've seen no huge chub in the swim yet. Doesn't mean they're in. They can't really get out of here. See if a red make a difference, see if we get a bite straight away, shall we? The cows are going for it in the field. Oh, Mr. Big Chub, you must be hungry. It's fish here, because I can see him as I move the float and just move out of the spook. If you can hear the cows making blowing through their nostrils at me. Going a bit quiet again. I'll find the fish again. Fish on. Fish off. Oh, what? I switched over to bread and I'm going to go over the far side. Just in front of that brick. No bites yet. I know there's fish in there, I can see them moving about. Probably see it's starting to get a bit darker now. Normally on the bread they normally attack it like mad and floats going all over the place. Nothing seemed to be happening there. Bridge staying on one. Maybe got three casts in the same bit of bread. See what happened over there. Come on, fishies.
going on? Pretty sure they don't want bread at the moment. And one more cast of it. Over the back there. Strange, it's gone a bit quiet. Normally if you land on the shoal move around in the swim. If you land on the shoal, you get a bite pretty much straight away. Pretty sure bread's not really doing much. I'm going to bait up over here with some maggots. We're all sitting there on the bread. Normally bread pick out a bigger fish, that's the thing. I don't know if we picked that up then, but big old heron just flew across the top of that hedge. Yeah? Yeah, I'm disappointed that Brett didn't do anything. Well, he worked well in this one. We only popped out for a couple of hours this evening. We've had a couple of fish already, so not too bad. It'd be nice if we can get a few more there. So we'll keep plugging away.
seeing if I can get a bite. Just can't seem to find any fish now. Strange out going here. Let's have a look over the back here, see if there's anything laying there. Fish are gone to bed. I know there's fish down there because I've seen them move, and I see quite a few when I first pulled up. And it doesn't mean they ain't gone through the bridge and just sitting in the reeds around the other side. Something's going on because I cannot get a bite now. Maybe a little pike or something in there, but I haven't seen one in there before. Doesn't mean there isn't one there. I'll turn you off for a minute and bring you back if we can get another fish. If not, it's going to be a fairly quiet night, this one. Well, we're starting to run out of light, but I keep seeing fish splashing further up here, so I'm going to never get any. Well, I had a fish on and lost it. But not going crazy tonight, is it? Bit slow tonight. Well, struggling in there tonight. I'm going to go back to the other bridge. We're on the float through a few times. And then probably call it a night. It's nearly dark now, but I'm going to push me luck and get an extra, hopefully 20 minutes. Did lose some chub while I was walking about in the river there. Cows then to come after us, we'd have probably done alright. Could see the big chub what I was looking for. Alright. Well, I'm drifting bread along the surface from the top of the bridge and I just lost a really big chub. I'm really annoyed. It took me around the trees and got me all tangled up. But I'm going to have another go because they're still coming up. Let's see if we can get one. Bit dark now, but let's have another go. Well, I've been climbing around in the bushes for hours now. Probably, don't know, 3.5-4 hours. Lost a really big chub. And I just landed this one. What a good fish. Light's not really doing it any justice. There's not much I can do. I've got none of my night gear with me. You can see us. Quite a decent sized fish. That's probably better. No, because it won't stay on. Can't get the lights to stay on. Batteries are flat. You get the idea, you can see that's a decent sized chub. Derrotum. So yeah, very nice. Easily over 4 pound, not going to weigh it. I've had 6 pounders before, but brilliant. At least we landed one in the end. Hard work, need to go in the water, but we got there in the end. It took 4 hours to get a fish in, but we done it. Wow. It was a bit harder session. When I just landed, I had to go in the river for as well. So I was halfway across the river. And I had gone like over the stone bit and down the other side of where the two rivers join. So that was fun. But I got in there and got out. The two I lost were way bigger than that, so they must have been over 6 pound. So I'm gonna be after them again. But we stuck it out. What's the time? Midnight. So we stuck it out for 4 hours to land a decent sized chub, and that's what we done. There's some small ones earlier on as well. So we've done okay. I'm knackered now, but I've got the hour's drive home now to the new home. But yeah, we've done alright. I'm happy with the 4-pound jab and the smaller ones. Did have a couple of roach while off camera as well. While I was charging up, and that's when the dark got none of my gear with me, so yeah, so we've done okay. Alright, so I'll spin you around and we'll do our drive out. So thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, all that sort of stuff. I'll see you soon in another video.